Hey.
What's that?
Cereal bar.
That yours?
No one else eats sweets around here.
I bought those for Kyle, you clown.
Kyle?
My nephew, who you're treating for.
Oh.
And why are you looking so smart?
Kyle.
You've forgotten, haven't you?
No.
How could you?
I'm so sorry.
He's on his way as well.
What are you doing?
Cancelling.
Hold tight. Hey, what's up, Leon?
Sup?
What are you up to today?
Chilling.
Yeah, well, about that, I need a favour. Carl's coming over for some tutoring today.
Well, that's cool. I'll make sure to keep out of the way.
Yeah, well, I'm at work.
And I'm seeing a friend.
She's on a date.
So who's gonna tutor Kyle? No.
Come on.
No!
But he's only 11. Key stage one, easy.
Key stage two.
Huh?
11 years old is key stage two.
Look, whatever, man. It's only an hour.
I had plans. All right, what time is it coming over?
Leon, you are a star. I'm cooking this evening, yeah? Ashley's got the deets, yeah? Later, I'm out.
Don't worry, he's a good kid. He brings his own books and packed lunch. Oh yeah, if he needs a break, let him. Thanks, I feel really bad. Remember, it's my turn to cook this evening. It's a special.
A special.
Oh, you must be Kyle. I'm Leon, your tutor. Come on through. Oh, would you like anything to drink?
I'm okay, thank you.
Anything to eat?
I'm okay, thank you.
Well, toilet is through there if you need it, and study room is just there. Alright, guess we best get started. Like English?
Yeah.
It shows. This is very impressive, girl. Well done.
I prefer science and maths though. I want to be a doctor like my dad.
Yeah?
Sometimes I struggle with maths, so probably don't have enough.
Listen, girl. You can do whatever you want to do in life. It's all about practice. You know, you just gotta keep striving for greatness.
What do you do?
Oh, I'm a DJ. I spin records. And when I started out, I struggled. I didn't have a great ear for certain type of tracks. But now, I'm pretty good. So there's always room for improvement. Always. Take a break.
Okay.
Oh, hell no.
254 plus 73.
327.
481 plus 55.
536.
98 times 22.
900.
Incredible. What's funny?
Just joking. It's 2156.
Of course I knew that. I'm an adult. Listen, why don't you go and watch TV? Go on.
Hello.
Hey, Ashley. Hey.
So how was it?
Incredible. His spelling was on point. Math was flawless. He didn't even need a calculator.
Amazing.
It really was. But how was your date?
Don't ask.
Oh no.
Kept me waiting in the park for almost an hour.
You're joking.
And then when he did turn up, he was with an entourage.
No way.
Yeah, him and one other goon. I didn't stay. Didn't even speak to him.
Well, how do you know it was him? Could have been someone else.
He was wearing the same jacket in his profile picture.
Yeah, that's why I hate dating apps.
What do you mean?
I mean, it takes like 2 months to get to know the girl. And then you don't really know her because you've never seen her. And then when you first meet up, she looks nothing like she does on her profile. So you start questioning all the things you told her, all the compliments and secrets you shared, and you feel like, rah, you have been scammed. False advertising. Then when you meet her, she expects you to pay for everything. And I mean, I'm a gentleman and all, but you're expecting me to pick up all the bills. Nah. And then you realize you have nothing in common with the person and you never see them again. So it's a whole waste of time.
Yep, that's women for you on dating apps. Hashtag waste my time 2018.
What about you guys? Why do men feel the need to post topless? It's a dating app and not a porn site. Don't start every conversation with, hey, how are you? I'm fine. No, actually I'm not. I hate my boss at work. I can't get my eyeliner to match. Wait, do you actually care about anything I just said? No, so don't ask generic questions then. Also, own your height. I'm not in this game for a midget. Why put 6'2" if you're really 5'3"? Don't you dare get me started on the B word. Hey babe, sure babe, how you doing babe? I'm not your babe. I have a mum and dad and they gave me a name. If we meet and date for a while and you manage to sleep with me and you call me babe during sex, not only will I never speak to you again, but I may chop off your balls and hand them to you on a platter. I'm joking about the last part.
I don't understand. You're a successful, strong businesswoman.
I wouldn't go that far.
Well, I don't know that many 24 years old hot dealers.
There's a few of us.
Well, I'm sure there's someone out there for you.
Stop it.
I ask myself every day, why am I still single? I mean, look at me, a young Congolese warrior.
You're a joker.
So, aren't you going to tell me about this latest artwork?
Really?
Yes, I'm fascinated by it.
Well, it's called Born King and Born Queen. The image is obviously of a child, can't be older than 6 years old. The crown is inspired by Basquiat. So he used a lot of crowns in his artwork, mainly on black icons or black people he considered heroes. The crown obviously represents royalty.
Future kings and queens?
No, that they're royalty now. And any adversity and obstacles that they may face in the future, they'll be able to overcome. Black excellence.
That's dope. That's really dope. Hey Kwame.
Hey.
Hey, how you doing?
How's work?
Yeah, it wasn't too bad. How's the kid?
The kid was a genius.
Guys, sit down, I'm making dinner this evening.
Nah, it's fine, I got this.
That's why I got the ingredients ready.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
I was gonna make my special.
Wait guys, there's always room for two courses, right?
Yeah.
So what were you guys going to cook?
Jollof. Kwame, like I said, sit down, I've got the ingredients ready.
Do you know what? I'm not hungry.
What?
Yeah, I've lost my appetite.
No, you haven't. Wait, you don't like my cooking.
Do you know what? It's not that.
What is it then?
Well, you're Nigerian and you're making jollof rice.
Go on.
But everyone knows it's a Ghanaian dish.
Oh no.
Really?
So Kwame, how are things in the banking world?
Let's be real.
I think that's the most foolish thing I've ever heard you say.
I'm just going to my room.
No, stay.
How's it foolish?
Everyone knows Nigerians do jollof better.
Don't play yourself.
I didn't even know Ghanaians did jollof until I met you.
What? It's all about African unity. Does this even matter?
Yes. Your country's jollof is unnecessarily spicy.
Your country's jollof has no real substance.
Claim Kenke, claim Banku, but don't try and claim jollof.
What do you think about this, Leon?
You can't ask me that.
He knows I'm right.
Look, watch me make it.
No, watch me make it.
Okay. We both can. Leon, you can be the judge.
Okay.
Oh,
Is there any need for the blindfolding?
Yeah, favoritism. Congo is closer to Nigeria.
Yeah, just to state, jollof originates from
Ghana.
It's a Senegalese dish.
Look, whatever. Look, just hurry up.
This is good. This is really good.
Okay, now taste this one.
This is wonderful. Wonderful.
Yeah?
It's incredible.
Prefer it to the first one.
The first one was incredible too.
Oh, make your mind up.
Guys, don't do this to me.
Pick one.
You do have one, right?
Yeah. Okay, guys. Just to say, I love you both, and it's not personal.
Get on with it.
My favorite jollof dish is...
You know, I wish I was sent back when I was younger.
What?
When you got into trouble and your parents sent you back?
What are you on about? Sent back where?
To Ghana.
You can always go back.
Nah. It's not the same. I go there and I'm trying to play catch up with my culture. You know, trying to learn the language, trying to trace my ancestry. It's not the same.
It's not a sprint.
You don't get it.
Why is everything a competition to you?
How many times have you been to Nigeria?
That's not the point.
No, go on. How many times?
Okay, never, but every day I'm excited to learn about my origins and I love my country.
How can you love somewhere you've never been to?
You've been to Ghana once.
Exactly. And for 1 week. I mean, how can I claim that my jollof is the best if I've never really been home?
Are we still arguing about jollof?
You know, I got into a fight back in the day. You know them ones where the whole playground comes together and forms a circle? Anyway, me and this guy Marvin got into a fight. You know, both got detentions. When I got home, my dad gave me the biggest whipping. You know, I even had a phobia of belts for a while. I didn't realise at the time, but it was the best thing that ever happened to me.
We all got disciplined.
Funny thing is, when I came into school the following week, Marvin was gone. Whole school was like, where's Marvin? Where's Marvin? It was only a few years later when I saw him at a baby shower, I realised where he'd really gone.
Ghana.
Told me it was the best thing that ever happened to him. Told me it gave him character. I mean, he learned Ga, traced his ancestry, travelled the whole country. I mean, he even told me that the locals gave him a nickname. Nature boy. Nature boy. I wish it had been me.
Hey, it's okay, Kwan.
Why do you always have to be the strong one?
Because she is.